Chapter 10 talks about triads, which are a kind of harmony. Harmony, of course, means when you have more than one note at the same time. But a triad especially means three notes, and each one is a third apart. And that's called a tertian triad, because there are other kinds of ways to have harmony, but we're not going to talk about it in this class. We're going to concentrate on tertian harmony, or harmony made up of consecutive thirds. And you know from your interval study that each one of these are a third apart because they're all in the space or all on a line. And these are different kinds of triads that we'll talk about in just a bit. So for right now, a triad is a three-note chord, and each note is a third apart. And when they are like that, then the bottom note, which is always called the bass note, but now the bottom note is the root of the chord. This chord is F-A-C. F is the lowest note. F is the root. Don't be confused. There'll be other times when the lowest note is not the root. But if they're stacked thirds, like I like to say, this looks like a little snowman, then the bottom note will be the root. So the root of this triad is F, A-flat for that one, G-sharp for that one, and E for that one. But there's more to know about them, including the names of the other notes in the chord. The root is the bottom one. The middle one is called the third, and the top one is called the fifth. That's because if you went up the scale, this would be the third scale note, and that would be the fifth scale note. So root on the bottom, third in the middle, fifth on top of this scale. And when the root is the lowest note, or that's called the bass, like I said, then we say it's in root position. So all these guys, these little snowman-looking things, are root position triads with the root on the bottom and giving the chord its name, F, A-flat, G-sharp, E, but then there's other things to know too. These chords are not all the same. The distance from these different notes varies in all of these, and that gives the triad the quality or the flavor of it. And there's four that there can be, but we're going to start with majors and minors. I'd like you to hear those for just a second. Now, the way to tell those apart, to hear them, is pretty clear. But how about if you look at them? Well, if we look at the way these notes relate to each other, this is the lower third, this is the upper third. If you have a major triad, from the bottom note to the middle note will be a major third, or four half steps. And from the third to the fifth, the higher two, will be a minor third, or three half steps. Major third here, minor third here. Major third here, minor third here. Major third here, minor third here. Major third here, minor third right there. Now you can count the half steps, you can see if it's major and minor third, but you can also look at the key signature, because if it follows the key signature, it's going to be a major triad, or the key signature of a minor key. Like this one right here, A, C, E. A, the key signature for A minor is no sharps and flats, so we know that is an A minor triad. We could also say, okay, that's a minor third, that's a major third. That's how minor triads work. Minor third on the bottom, major third on the bottom. They'd like you to start in this book, though, by using the key signature rule, which is probably a good way to do it. The key signature for F major is one flat. B flat doesn't affect that, so that is F major. The key signature for F minor is B flat, E flat, A flat, D flat. It has the A flat, so that's F minor. B flat major has two flats, B flat and E flat, so that fits the B flat major key signature. And B flat minor has B flat, E flat, A flat, D flat, G flat, so that fits that key signature also. So that's another way to tell if those are major or minor, and they can be other things too, like I said. One other little thing you need to know, though, we still consider it a triad, even if the notes occur one at a time, which is how I played them for you on the sound file. And when they are broken up like that, it's called arpeggiated, which comes from the Latin word arpeggio, which means like a harp, because if you played them on the harp, you'd probably play one note at a time. So this is a block chord or chordal triad. This is an arpeggiated triad, still a triad. That's because they occur one at a time instead of together. Doesn't change all that.